Welcome to Date with Dhanu, right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. So we took a small break because of everything that was happening out there. So right now we are in a safe space and we thought we will bring a show to you with a new regulations in mind. Thank you for joining us on Date with Dhanu. Today I'm going to be speaking to two personalities I have known literally all my life. They have known me from a young, tender age, but they were way older than me at that time as well. And today I'm so happy to have them treasure some great memories. You would have seen them on stage. You would have seen them in different circles. Today we'll come to know more about them, apart from the things we know. And as my first guest on the show, I have someone who gave me attitude as his first sentence to me. It was long years ago when I admired his presence on TV and I was like, I have seen you somewhere. Oh yeah, I read news. Those were his exact words to me with his light blue striped t-shirt. But that scarred me for life. But eventually, I was able to find a friend in him. I'm happy to have the very well-spoken and someone who has contributed so much to this country and continues to do so when it comes to his foreign policies and his work with the diplomatic circle. I'm happy to have George Cook.
Hi, I'm George, and I'm involved in the field of international relations in education and research. And I'm here to go on a date with Dhanu. And this has been something that has been in the planning for quite some time and is finally happening. A Date with Dhanu is fast becoming one of the most impressive English TV programs around at the moment in this country. Well, I've known Dhanu for more than two decades, ever since he started acting a long, long time ago, and he was back in school at the time. And he's always had this major comment to make, and I'm sure you're going to hear more about it today as well, in terms of pronunciation. And he has a huge issue with it and loves to thrash me in the process every time he gets the opportunity of introducing me. He must bring up this whole issue of pronunciation, which I am rather insistent on, and he doesn't seem to be rather concerned about. And this is something that has become a huge issue for him, and he keeps raising this every time we meet someone.
So I have George Cook. You have seen him on Hi TV with a Sri Lankan Understanding. And this time around, we have reversed the seating and I put him there. Thank you for being on the show, George.
Thanks for having me.
I'm hosting this show nearly after 5 months. So I'm also a bit rusted.
So it's good to be on the show then.
Yeah. I want to be precise when I talk to George. I don't want to just blabber in the words without making it articulated and perfect. George, you have been in the public eye for a long time. What made you enter media?
I just finished school and I was looking for things to do and I started teaching straight away. But I also thought media was something interesting to get into and I applied. And I actually applied for two positions. There was newscaster and news presenter because I saw the advertisements on two different days. And
but
I
both
applied.
Are the same, right?
Yes, but I think the caster was more in terms of actually gathering the information, gathering and putting it together. It was based in Colombo, whereas the other one was going to the studio. And then I applied for both, and then I was called for the interview, and I was asked, which one do you want? Because you've applied for both. And so I said, let's look at the two of them. And so presenter started, and that's how it started back in, a long time ago, 1998.
Yeah. But everyone has doubted the fact that you wore contacts all your life. It has been a conversation. How did you prove it wrong?
I tried to knock my eyes out and nothing happens. And then as a result, they realize it's real.
When I was in school, when I was a young boy, living down Arithuza Lane, my mom used to watch you at the 8:55 bulletin, correct? Yeah, but you already read for 5 minutes.
It was a 5 to 10 minute. It was a roundup. It was the most important news and it came before all the other main channels started at 9.
Right. So this was going from Behivala all the way to Piliandala. Just to read for 5 minutes was a lot of work.
It was a lot. It was a very long evening. We started around 5 or 5:30 the journey.
Oh, yeah.
And I got home around 10:30.
To be on TV for 5 minutes. I'm sure the experience was great.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
So you never wanted to make media your full-time career?
You see, I've never put all my eggs into one basket. I've always felt the need to diversify. Media was something that I went into TV and then I went into radio after that. But I also liked the teaching component, so I continued in that field, in education. And then, of course, in the field of education, having started off with speech and drama, I also moved into international relations.
which was my area of study by then. And then that took over to a large extent. But then I've kind of returned to something to do with social media right now. So there's been, I've not moved too far away from the media.
Now it's time that we put some color onto this show. Because with George, it's going to be very, just very normal, in a good way. We have someone who is sensational. Her hourglass figure, her amazing fashion sense, her beautiful eye makeup, her presence on stage has captivated Colombo. She's the ever so gorgeous Chris Sosa. I got the script right, right? Yeah. Chris Sosa.
Hi everyone, I'm Chris Sosa. Let me start by saying that I live in Nugegoda, lovely Nugegoda. I have worked as a journalist, a newsreader actually, and I have also worked at Sri Lankan Airlines. That was a great job. What else? I love animals. I feed at least 6 street dogs. And they tear up my house and my shoes and everything possible, but I love them. I'm very excited about doing this show. I have actually watched several episodes with lots of famous people, and I'm quite honored to be considered a famous person to go on a date with Danu. Danu has harassed me for at least 20 years now. Basically, he has actually harassed me. Never says anything nice about me. Always like says, "Are your eyebrows are too bushy?" or like caterpillars, or "You have got dark," or something like that. So, anyway, that's Danu in a nutshell.
And we have Chris Sosa. Thanks for being on the show, Chris.
Thank you.
You look fabulous.
Thank you. But I didn't look fabulous when I came.
Yeah, we all look terrible.
My gosh, when I went into the salon, people, like the silence, and people were like putting their hands over their mouth. And
but did that person call you when you were plucking your nose hair in the balcony?
They didn't call me anything. Mm-hmm. They shouted from the road because I was like, not nose hair. I don't have nose hair. It was my eyebrows and also the upper lip. Like I was like doing. And then from downstairs I can hear like somebody shouting, "Reula Banava." So this is very ugly because there are people on the road.
Yeah, true. They might have thought whether you are giving the service or whether you wanted the service.
No, like they are just commenting. Sri Lanka, they want to have a background commentary to my plucking my whatever.
Bush.
A bush.
Yeah, but it wasn't
a bush. No, just stray hairs.
Now I have known them for a long time. I've known both of them since I was like 15, I think. Both of them gave me attitude, especially Chris. More obviously, like she never even considered me human. I've done multiple plays with her. The first 12 plays, I think I was insignificant. I was a part of the prop. She's like, and the chairs and Danu can just get out. it was one of that. But then you started liking me and then loving me. And now you just adore me.
It was like, it was, otherwise my conscience would be like, it would bother me in the night.
Because very rarely you get attached to someone. It takes a long time for
Long time. I have...
You have trust issues or that's who you are?
That's who I am. Because I need like 2 meter distance. Corona actually is ideal.
For you.
To like...
You're not the huggy type and like...
No. If I want to hug, I will hug. But I don't like anyone like trying to hug me because they're all like usually bigger.
Right.
And I can feel like my heart like... constricting when they hug me.
Yeah.
So I don't like...
But I'm so happy that we are one happy family now. That we have found some kind of a link that connects all three of us together.
Yes. A link.
Yeah. So George, you are into foreign policies and you've worked with the diplomatic circle for a long time. Not anymore. But let's talk about what made you work. And you lived in France, you worked with policies and worked with relationships. Do you think Sri Lanka is on a good level there? Like, are we doing good with other countries or they're just tolerating us?
Well, ours is a country that has had an amazing past.
I'm talking about prison.
I know, I need to go there, bring you back here.
So when you look at what we have achieved there, there's a lot more that we can achieve now. It's got so much of potential. We've got, and that's where we've started the show too, the Sri Lankan Understanding, to talk about the potential of this island nation. This is not just another country somewhere on the planet. It is from a global perspective, but there's lots more we can do with our country. And that's what we really need to keep pushing all the time.
George for president. We'll see you after the break. Do stick around. Stay with us. They say the most compassionate people are the ones who love animals. Chris is someone like that.
Yes.
Yeah.
I love you, so... Sorry. So what were you saying? Yes.
Animals.
Animals, yes.
But I feel like there's discrimination in your house with the fact that the internationally known dogs like Labs and Boxers and all of them are kept indoors and the street pooches like me have been kept out. Why
is that? But like in the middle of the night, they start howling, wanting to go out. So can I be like, you know, the street ones want their freedom. They want like to just
But I feel like, you know, like it's just that they don't have so much of fur for them to feel the wind.
No, but they like that kind of freedom. They don't want to be constricted in a bedroom and on a bed, which the Labradors and other...
I'm just going to leave that for the comments.
No, that, I mean...
Maybe you should close the gates once the others come in. So yeah, they can run around the garden and go crazy in there.
Yes, they run around the garden and destroy everything. Yes, during COVID also, that was like a small
incident
involving my mother.
Ah, right. Yeah. Right. So actually, Chris's mom is really interesting.
Yes, very, if you call, yes, interesting is
the right word.
The right word, yeah. It's never boring with her.
Now, George hosted Chris in France during his time overlooking the Eiffel Tower.
Yes, very nice it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he cooked and cleaned. And
everything, like very domesticated.
Yeah, like he was like that god Shiva with several hands because he could do like
multiple things. But tell me, you told me that George wore the national
costume, yes,
of Sri Lanka.
Yeah, the Arya Singhal.
Not the Nilame, right?
No, the Arya Singhal costume, okay. the white one, because okay. he had to. Now we are traveling by train, no?
Metro.
So we don't have cars and stuff there, no, by ourselves. So. Metro. So George runs into the metro with the national dress, which
they must be thinking it's your sleepwear.
No, it's something that they realize.
No, but it was like I said, George, like, you know, because at that time I didn't realize the value, like, and I was self-conscious. So I said, George, like, won't you feel like a little, you know, don't you want to go to work
and
at this
change.
Function? He was dressing for a function. And change there, like,
but
won't
no.
you? He said, no, why? Everybody, why? That was a man who actually admired me, he said.
Mom, maybe but, like if Mahatma Gandhi can walk around with just a piece of cloth.
But that is, it's a bit cold.
Invariably, you're wearing a massive overcoat and over it like, and they can only see the bottom of it
and
on the road.
His chest is. chest is hairy.
Who's his?
George.
Not Gandhi's. How do you know Gandhi's chest?
No, I am talking about George's chest.
How do you know George's chest?
I have seen George's chest.
How did she see your chest?
I have no idea. Don't ask me, ask her.
We have slept on a bed together. But
with several other people who were also sitting there and we were talking. We were all sitting and talking.
Yes, actually.
But why was his chest hair exposed?
I have like a very close relationship with George. I have helped to dress him.
Never. Imagination running riot.
Once in a way. Why I have asked, you know, is this
you
see-through?
Have, like, Chris, let, okay, let's ask this question. Do I have a hairy chest?
I have not seen your
there
chest.
There you go. That answers
but
all the
questions.
But
he was my boss, no?
When did bosses show their hairy chest to their employers?
No, I have helped him inter. Like,
but
suddenly, if
where
like,
did y'all work?
Achar or something falls on his nice shirt. Like, I have like, ended.
I don't know the last time I ate acharu, but okay.
In the newsroom, we have eaten acharu and done things. I mean,
edited the news.
Teamwork. You know, and bonded and all that.
Yeah. Everything sounds really bad. There's also the word bonded in all of this. Let's get into a break because we have a hot seat coming on the other side. Actually, we are just getting into hot seat. I'm just so confused with everything that's happening. We'll see you after this. One of my favorite segments, they are fighting for a gift bag from Crystal Skin Clinic. George Olive's fruits. And I told him he needs all the help. I mean, from Crystal. No, not in a bad way, for the services they provide to enhance your beauty.
I don't think he needs to get more beautiful, Danu, than
but you
this.
Have always been beautiful, Chris.
Yeah, that is because now Ramani, they like in the emergency room jumping on a patient. They jumped on me when I walked in. They jumped on, like, they. I think one girl put the sign of the cross also. And they saw because
means on you or on themselves?
On themselves.
Ah, right. Chris, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, these are hot seat questions you can't take forever to answer. Please quickly answer. Sri Lankan Airlines, Petwe Care. Which job was easier for you to resign from?
Petwe Care. Petwe Care? No, Petwet.
Petwet. You resigned from Petwet.
Petwet.
That was easier for you to resign from.
Easier, yes.
From the following list, rank Indu Dharmasena's actors from your favorite to your least favorite, because all three of us have acted with Indu Dharmasena, and that's how I actually met Chris and George. Here are your names. George Cook, Gihan Kure, Michael Holsinger, Michelle Herft, Danu Inasithambi.
Definitely Michael Holsinger. Because
is your favorite?
I have a terrible crush on Michael Holsinger.
Least favorite?
I don't know. I can't say like that.
You have other names. You have George Cook, Gihan Kure, Michelle Herft and Danu.
Well, the person I have worked least with is Michelle.
Okay.
So,
from the following list, who do you think deserves to be in the parliament once again? Duminda Silva, Milinda Morogoda, Upeksha Swarnamali, Mervin Silva, Mangala Samaravira.
My God, I think I'll have to say, was Upeksha Swarnamali in that?
Yeah.
That.
Really?
Her, yes.
Okay. Was known as Paba. As you communicate with them on social media, your favorite Rajapaksa sibling, Namal, Yoshita, Rohita.
Yoshita, I think.
Give the following people a ministry to run. Otara.
Animal welfare, if there is such a ministry.
Dominic Keller.
Men's affairs.
Men's affairs? Men's affairs.
Men's affairs.
Sanat Jayasurya.
Agriculture. But he said something about the sand
coming out. Soundari David.
Music and entertainment.
A ministry for that?
I don't know, sir.
Cultural.
No, music and entertainment.
Right, that's what you are choosing. George Cook.
I thought you were asking him.
I'm asking.
George Cook. Pronunciation and grammar.
They'll have to reset the parliament. George Cook, ready?
She's finished.
Yeah. Oh, five questions. Well done, Chris.
Thank you.
Very well done. Your all-time favorite anchor on a news desk? Noeline Hunter, Siobhan Daniel, Ashan Dias, Manalka Phillips.
Noeline Hunter.
Rank in order of preferences your favorite compere for an event and why? Kumar De Silva, Arun Dias Bandaranaike, Adam Ali.
Each of them represents a different genre and each of them has a different contribution to the field. That's so mean, Chris.
I'm fighting for a voucher.
A gift bag. Say it nicely.
Yeah, I'm fighting for a gift here.
Kumar De Silva. Very versatile. Very versatile presenter.
Simple answer.
Simple.
Explain in one word what you think is the biggest downfall in our foreign policy.
Direction.
If you can bring back one president, who would you choose from the following and why? JR, CBK, MR, MS, MY3. Rana Singha Premadasa, I don't know how to say that part. He didn't have like a short form. Who would you choose?
None of them. Because they've had their turn, they've done their work, and now they're part of history.
If you were to nominate the next presidential candidate, who would you pick from the following? Now you are nominating, okay? Kumar Sangakkara, Arjun Aloysius, Basil Rajapaksa, Ranil Wickremesinghe, Hironika Premachandra.
Kumar.
From the following list, rank Indudharma Sena's actors from your favorite to your least favorite. This question was put as you to give an answer. Chris Sosa, Gihan Kure, Michael Holsinger, Michelle Herft, Danu Inasithambi.
It has to be Chris. We've had a ball on stage.
No, but... So Chris would
come
first.
I'll give him the voucher now.
Chris would come first.
Give him the voucher.
And then least?
You have been fun to work with on stage, so you'd come second.
You've chosen me second. I didn't ask for the first, second, third, fourth.
You wanted the first and
first
the last.
First and the last. If you are putting me in the second, you could have just stopped saying that.
With the other three, I haven't worked to that extent. We've worked, but not as much as I've worked with Chris.
So?
The least.
All the other three would fall into that category.
So that means I am least now.
No. You're second.
But that's worse than being least.
Why?
George, either I have to be number one, or you can be like,
you're number two.
Afterthought. Like,
no, oh, so who have you worked with least?
Number one is Chris, number two is you, and the least is the other three.
You were just overshadowed by me. Well, I must say, Chris, hands down, you are the winner.
Thank you.
Although you might have the least amount of work to do at Crystal, you are still the winner. We will contribute this to George.
Do you think that has got a better advantage in life from the minute he came out of his mother's womb?
That is true because of his skin color.
He had to fight like a dog
to look like
For all the school players, like because I am like a vellavahum, like.
Yeah. I've seen you before the grooming.
No need to go into dark places.
It but was dark.
He has never had any issues.
Yeah, of course, I've ever.
This is only he'll be on the fan. George will lose all his hair.
Sparkling like that, like a river.
Yeah. So what shall we do then?
Mm-hmm. So if he wants, then give.
But I'll give it to you, Chris.
No, it's okay. Now
But I'm telling you, they might just send you back saying you're perfect.
Yeah, they might. Then I'll give George.
No,
give it to him.
After she goes there.
Give. I'll just give it to him.
Just throw it at him. Just throw it.
Valuable voucher.
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, George.
Chris, you know what? I'll give you one when you're going.
No, because he doesn't need any more.
That is true. It's very obvious.
He's very ugly.
He's in makeup 24/7.
Both of us will go together.
No, there won't be anything remaining on that voucher after they're done with you.
Right. Insulted to the core. Chris, at least come with me for company.
And then everybody will be dancing around him like butterflies, and I'll be like the outsider.
Sudhu ekkenek, sudhu ekkenek.
Let's get into a break. We'll
see you after the break.
Break now.
Welcome back to the show. In conversation with George Cook and Chris Sosa. As always, I love these two and it's always a pleasure to have you on the show. George, let's speak a little bit about your new endeavors that you have got into. You are someone who has always loved this country so much. You have always wanted to promote this country on a global platform. Although a lot of people have mistaken you for coming from a different country, I think you are as Sri Lankan can get, someone who always pins the flag so proud on your chest. So tell me, as someone who is so passionate about this country, do you feel this country and the policies and the system has let you down for you to move away from the services that you can do in the Foreign Service?
Well, that's a chapter that I closed some time ago. 2017 or so when I left the Foreign Service for various other reasons. But I'm very much involved in the field of international relations. I have not left the field. I love the field, whether it's in the teaching of the field or the research of the field. And I've gone into the area of building awareness, increasing engagement, increasing dialogue.
Is there a youth interest towards this?
Absolutely, there is. Because lots of people are looking at how they can use international relations, mainly from those who are already in other professions. But of course, from a youth perspective, it's very important because now they're beginning to realize the connectivity with the world. From the things we eat, to the things we wear, to the things that we use, this is all coming from the outside world. Mm. We really need to be working with the outside world. We are an island, but we're not an island in that sense of the word.
So do you feel that we have a long way to go in terms of maintaining great relationships? Or do you feel that the countries internationally see us with a bit of a black patch these days?
We need to do a lot more in terms of strategy, in terms of where we want to get to, what we want to achieve, what our objectives should be. That is something we have to work on. And that is something that we haven't done enough in that arena.
Chris, now yes. I feel like we should leave the show.
No, I'm like, you have not asked me any important questions like that. Oh, I got some Rahul Abano and some things like that. This one is like about to get the Nobel Peace Prize.
Yeah. But Chris, you're very passionate about a few things and you keep it like that. Just wanted to ask you, you left the corporate world.
Yes.
Why?
Only because I actually applied for PR in another country. And because I didn't, my husband didn't want me to waste that money. So I went abroad.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you have always enjoyed working?
Yeah, I love working. But now I'm a slave at home.
Yeah. Far from it. Yeah. She doesn't do anything.
She never enjoyed working.
I loved working. Oh my God. Remember, like, I used to, like, ask
what?
You.
You hate
talk about
work.
The work side only.
I loved work, actually. I mean,
and you also did such very different fields,
yes,
like in aviation, in pets,
journalism. Pets. So,
like, why? Why so? Like,
because they were the only ones willing to give me a job. It went because I never, like, when I got married, it was like a very conventional thing. Like, I was supposed to stay at home, not supposed to, but. That's what I thought would happen.
Like be a housewife.
Yeah. Then it like got a bit like dull.
Yeah.
So then, so I started working late. I got married early.
Yeah. And
then started working a bit later when I was bored out of my mind.
So we are playing another game right now.
Okay.
And these are the fun things that I love to do. And it's called One Word. I'm going to tell you all about it when we do come back.
Please, Dadu, don't mention that, right?
Welcome back to the show.
I can't have guests on my show if you mention that. Don't say that.
We are actually recording. We are talking about Sri Lankan understanding on HAI. You can watch it on Wednesdays on HAI TV. There, a plug-in for your show.
Much needed oxygen, I think, for the...
Which is hosted by George Cook. All right. So this game is called One Word, but you have to lie. You can't tell the truth as you answer. Okay, are you ready? I'll start with George.
Yeah,
this time.
Start with George.
All right. Your favorite physical feature?
Fingers.
Your favorite...
Face.
No, it's not your real your favorite. You're supposed to lie, Chris.
Oh, you have fingers on your face.
Did he say on my face?
No, he didn't say physical.
Chris, you're getting everything wrong, Chris.
Physical features.
And he said fingers.
Physical means from here to there, Chris.
Right. Your favorite household chore?
Sweeping.
One thing you enjoyed trying and will definitely try again?
Something I've tried and will try again. Blue cheese.
I feel like it's a good. If there was a second life, would you lie to come back as a man or a woman? Would you like to come as a man or a woman?
Lie about it. So then woman.
So that means you want to come back as a man then?
Why,
what's wrong with coming back
sexist.
As a woman?
Yeah. Sexist.
Very sexist.
Is what is wrong in coming back as a woman?
Do you
feel like as if you have an advantage?
Is that the reason, George?
Is that the reason?
Do we have another break coming up?
Yeah.
But that's the truth, Jo.
No, I want to leave this.
Yeah. I don't mind either.
You had to lie, but you lied saying.
But I'm not coming back again then.
Please don't go into philosophical thing. What's your name?
Danu.
Okay. What school are you from?
St. Peter's.
Your girlfriend's name?
Chris.
You're boring. Chris, to you.
Ayo.
Actually, he lost that
terribly.
That was so
tough. What's the gift?
I'll tell you about it later, okay?
That also they won't give me. They'll give you.
To help me.
What would you rather be doing now?
See how tough it is?
Yes, yes.
Good for you now.
But
you wanted it now?
What would I rather be doing now? Having lunch with George.
What you would never buy with your own money?
What would I never buy? A dog.
Your personality.
Yes, what's the question? What's the question?
Good, bad, romantic or defensive?
Good.
The first thing you notice in others?
Their smile.
What do you notice then? For real?
Yes.
If you could go under the knife, which part of your body would you like to work on?
Legs.
That's a real.
Why, I have to lie, no?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You like your legs?
I think that's like a decent part of my body.
Your full name?
Bhavanta.
Full name is Bhavanta?
Bhavanta Samanalavati Aryasen.
Aryasen. How old are you?
80.
Where are you from?
Hapugas Pen.
Chris, you win this round as well.
Thank you.
Such easy Thank questions you. For her.
Wow, but George, you just overthink everything.
I think he's just like
the clothes that you
victim.
Wear.
He wants to be the victim.
Yeah, you're playing the victim card.
Victim.
I think we are going in for a break. Yeah. Can you read that?
No, I can't. I have one eye looking this way, one eye looking that way.
Yes, it's time for a break.
That's written in red or black?
As the 26-year-old on the couch here, I think I know it's a break time.
That is true. We'll see you after break. Welcome back to the show. It's time that we put them in a spot. And it's called Sticky Situ. George, I'm going to start with you.
Good.
As always.
How corrupted is the foreign ministry? Or is it? Or is it not?
It's not.
It's not. Do you think everyone works keeping the country as priority?
They try.
Okay. Where do you think the problem is?
Strategy.
Whose strategy?
Lack of it.
Okay. Overall. And who is to be blamed?
It's an overall need to change. It has to change with the system.
So after independence, we haven't still got our strategy sorted. We can get our roads sorted, but we can't get the strategies. As someone who was in it, where would you see the problem? Where are the cracks?
Direction.
Go and give me one word answers, George. What is this? Riddle.
He thought it's one word.
I thought we were playing the earlier game again also.
Direction. Go on saying words of the dictionary. Tell me something in sentence.
So one thing that can change is...
But you left it. That means you have either loved it so much you left it or you just got sick of it so you left it. What is it?
Neither. It wasn't to do with the service. It was to do with the overall direction of it.
Yeah.
Where it was going.
So directions are done by people, no?
Hmm.
So people are not exactly there for the fact that they want to bring the country forward.
You see, that is where we've got to focus now in terms of education. We've got to enhance education.
Are all the diplomats who are sent there educated enough to be in that position?
They are. They have passed efficiency bars. They have passed the required examinations, etc. But we've also now got to look at that bigger picture of understanding, doing research, going deeper into areas. The time when diplomats were generalists is going. It's fading. We've got to focus on being a specialist now. Mm. Specialization is becoming very, very important.
And do you think the system will change? Because Sri Lanka has been highlighted for violation, for corruption, for all of this. And do you think there'll be a change where our foreign policies will be stronger, will be more enriched, where other countries will not think twice about even giving us visas on the go? Would we come to that level?
So there are lots of factors that are going to contribute to that, Danu. It's not just the foreign ministry only. There are so many ministries. This is an entire country. We have so many issues to deal with on a daily basis. But whilst we are fighting fires on a daily basis, we also must be planning of what is going to happen. What is our target for the next year? What is our target for 2048 when we get to the centenary of our independence? Where do we want to be? We've got to be goal-oriented. Mm. Chris used the word target. We've got to have those goals. We've got to we've got to set those targets and go about achieving them and have milestones that we are going to overcome as we get there. So that is something that we need to do.
Chris, yes. You're someone who loves this country. You are very political about a few things. You're quite open on your social media.
You've been stalking.
I kind of stalked you a little bit. But you still worked on a citizenship to leave this country. Did you feel like this country let you down in any way?
The thing is, we applied for a PR when there was a war going on.
And that war,
it's like 30 years of my life.
Yeah, correct.
And it didn't seem like it was going to end. Because I didn't have faith at the time we applied that it would end. But the very next year, it ended. So, like, and our PR got approved. So, then it was, we had spent a bit of money.
And you thought it's just...
And I thought, okay, I have to, you know, after spending that, it's, I don't like to waste in any food or anything.
Yeah.
So my husband said, you know, I'm going to stay here. And since we've paid for this,
you go ahead
and get it. And maybe at least things might be easier to travel.
True. Because the visa will,
visa will be
a process that, because our country sends us nowhere. Like, not to Piliandale, even my visa has got rejected in Colombo. It's quite... what is this passport?
So it might be a bit easy.
Are you happy with the way this country is governed today?
There are a lot of the ways that it can improve. But I feel that we should give a chance. Right now it looks like almost as if the world is falling down.
Yes.
And everything is
like
there.
We are in a black hole.
Yeah, but I think we should give a chance at least and wait a little until...
Because I'm really worried about this, these luxury items tax and all. Like, and not coming into this country. If I have to buy a phone, I'll ask you, I'll take your passport, go and buy and come and give it to me.
But now,
it's like in the process.
They have so not
yet told, but it has come, no? If it comes, I'm having a contingency plan.
If it comes.
If it comes. But you are happy with where the country is going?
Well, in the last few days, I got some good news.
Okay.
Because I heard that there was a growth of 4.3% in the economy. And a projected growth would be over 10%. That's by speaking to people in finance and economy. I heard that kind of news. So that's kind of pleasant. Let alone politics. Anything good for the country we should be happy.
Definitely.
So,
George, if you were put into a national list and taken into parliament, would you? I don't think you'll be the contesting type because nobody will understand your English. You'll be another one of those candidates.
So many have already started asking that question in terms of the Avalog initiative that I've started or Sri Lankan understanding.
Well, they've already approached
Whether these are political aspirations.
Ah.
And I'm like, they're not.
But
this
would
is in
you?
The field of education.
Because you have enough and more clothes to get into the parliament.
Only time will tell.
So that's a no or a yes?
Time will tell.
Mike, that's a yes. I'm going to be best friends with you. You will not do any corruption. At least I'll just go in one of those vehicles. You might take the bus even then, no? But
why is it that you never wanted to drive, George?
Oh, that's another question.
I have a license.
Ask Willie Wu, the proper
why
ones.
Don't you? Why don't you want to?
I have a license.
Having a license is like having, like, I have got, I have got cards for everything, even to open a door.
Yeah.
But it's just that it's sometimes more convenient to be taken to a place than to be
going. Oh, you want to be sure for Japan?
Not exactly, but it's less risky.
Hmm. It's time that we play a game to ease this tension.
Yes, it's very tense.
Another game?
But you don't want to play it. Okay, then we'll not play.
How tough is it?
No, he only wants, if you dangle a voucher in front of him, he will play anything. He will even...
You are already becoming a politician. You want a gift in return. You want something to...
I never wanted anything.
So that's why...
I didn't win anything either.
He didn't refuse it.
Yeah.
Although I won it.
You said it openly, I don't want to know. And they're like,
open your lapel.
Yeah.
Open it, sir. No, show them the print.
Show from the other side, man.
Show the print inside. Yeah.
We have spent more
of this got to do with...
They are the jacket inside out. Because of that nice print.
Show yours.
And there's nothing. This is what you call a sticky situation. There's nothing. There's just silk.
Padded. No, sorry. I meant the jacket.
Padded.
The jacket, I said padded.
Always has something nasty to say.
Can we please get on with this game, please? It's a game, right? A break. Oh, I can't see anything, man. Let's get into a break. It's time that we go through their social media a little bit.
Oh, no.
And we did some digging. Welcome back. So before we go any further, just to clarify what Chris and George did, George ran a news desk and Chris was working with George.
Under George.
I wanted to use a better word.
Under George.
And
with.
But you have also shown many a things. You have seen many a
things.
And
he has also shown.
And George always uses big words. What is that word that he made use?
No, so in the morning, George pretends, because I'm the one who takes over from him. So George comes at 4 o'clock in the morning.
And fresh, good morning.
And
good morning.
Everybody said, please don't shout, I've got a hangover. And
yeah, I remember when he did he did a milk commercial as well, where he spoke to cows and all.
Yes. Sorry about
that. Pashas are green and
don't
plug in brands when they are not paying. Beep that brand here because they are not paying for the show.
Beep. So anyway, I remember when George... So anyway, George pretends that he's doing me a favor.
Which I was.
And prepares my...
What's the big word that he has given you?
Braggadotter.
If I had to read, that company would be closed by now. Braggadotter.
And that is not a normal spelling. It's a Norwegian sort of way that it's spelled.
But he knows how to read all
of
this.
He knows. He has practiced. And he's like banana slipping out of
the mouth. Yeah.
That it goes.
How do you know the...
have you ever had a banana slip out of your mouth?
No, because I don't think I've eaten
you
banana
eat
like
it,
that.
No, Chris, it doesn't come out from inside.
What were you doing sucking on a banana for it to slip?
But sometimes as a child, it has just slipped out.
Your childhood was long time
anyway,
ago.
Anyway, never mind. This one, all four new sports, foreign affairs, all those little bulletins, big words.
We will quickly do a demonstration of how George reads news. Both of us are George Cook at the news desk, okay? Good evening and welcome to your primetime news. I'm George Cook. Looking at your headlines this evening, the Prime Minister of Pakistan just visited Sri Lanka. Read your next headline.
Now, you can't just put it onto me like that. That's what I was going to say.
Ah, okay. Then you can use that big word, gabarajus.
Now, what was her name? Braggadotter? Please tell me.
I can't remember.
As if you can't.
Her full name.
I gave you things like Giska, very Giska Diestion.
Yes. But I have eternally let him down all of us have let him down. For tourist resort, we have
terrorist resort,
Schumacher's cow. George is pulling his hair and some tears in those piercing blue eyes of his.
But nothing. I actually said Grand Prix for Grand Prix.
I also have said Grand Prix. And lingerie for lingerie. Excitement.
I don't think we had lingerie on the news, Chris.
Can we get on with this last segment? Can you all talk about this thing somewhere else? Okay. So, looking at your social media, Chris, this sort of really portrays your personality. When all the others pose for a photo, you strike that pose.
So, otherwise it's boring, no?
Yeah.
To sit on a bridge and
look at Chris, legs wide open.
That is called the hell of a bridge.
Oh, right.
That is a bridge in the middle of nowhere that the British built 100 years ago.
George will know that.
By mistake. They were supposed to build it in Halavata and they built it in Helaba.
So this is in Sri Lanka.
Yeah, this is over Uma over here.
Let me see.
Okay. So while you all look at that, next picture I want to show is in George's house, there's only George's photos.
Really? George has never welcomed me much into his home.
Like, you'll only see this bit of a...
Ane, darling, look at this.
Take the two fish buns out, man.
Ane, look at
if me. You shave your beard, you'll look the same.
Ayo, this is so cute. I want this.
Take it.
Thank you.
Biff.
Ane, that's Biff.
Yeah.
Bania.
You only have international dogs in the house, no? Money. Chris, speak about this wonderful person.
That's my mother.
You can't see that close as well, no?
No, I like screen.
Yeah, sorry.
So that's my mom.
Yeah. Amazing person.
Definitely.
Keeps us entertained.
Definitely.
24/7. Oh.
This was after lunch one day.
Yeah.
Look at that.
I'm being tortured even back then, as you can see.
I, of course, look
the torturing hasn't changed.
A little dodgy.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, a little dodgy.
But just to give you an
example. It's the worst photo.
Yeah.
Where both of you all look nice and I look.
But just to give an
example. I don't get the voucher. No.
But just to give an example of how much fun Chris and I can have, here's a photo.
Is that the two of you?
Yes.
Where was this? Upcountry.
It was in Diyatala. A lot of Hindus plays.
You all are falling off your chairs.
Yeah.
We sang Kendila Missi to the...
Here is George looking absolutely gorgeous.
And me?
You, of course, always.
That is in Paris.
This was about 10 years ago.
Yeah.
This is Chris's husband who she occasionally checks whether he's still breathing. He has a delayed heart. He has a delayed heartbeat, right?
No. He has a slow pulse rate when he's sleeping. So sometimes it's as if he has died. No, he doesn't breathe. You had to several times I had to put my hand near his nose and or wake him and see, because sometimes it's as if he's dead.
That's Shara the Fayal.
Yeah. Finland.
Tell me, not for you to look at the picture, talk about it.
I don't know what is that.
This is this famous Indian singer who was absolutely fascinating. I mean...
Fascinated by you.
She was fascinating. This is her backstage having her hot whatever it is after singing.
Her hot whatever.
George, this is for you to talk about.
That's TNL Radio and the crew.
Am I there?
You're not there. This is pre-Chris.
That's a little unfair.
This was a long time ago.
Oh, that's my best friend, Lian. Yeah. My sister from another mother. Mother, mister. Lian. Oh, this is at Sanjana and Jehan's wedding.
Yeah, but look at us.
Look at us.
Chris hasn't changed a bit.
Yeah.
My hair is shorter. And I'm, I did my own makeup, by the way.
But she had like a raccoon look going at one point. When she did the whole black smoky eye makeup. Yeah. I actually asked her whether Sharada hammered her at home before she left.
And my gym instructor, Buddhika, he one day told me when I walked in, Miss Nikang, yakik wagaya.
She looked quite tragic.
It's like a compliment.
But before we wrap things up on the show, it's time that we go. I can't see anyone here because it's a different set and everyone is far away. Just a few things. I must say, George Cook. George has been such a great friend, a support, and someone who inspired me to study. And I will thank him for me finishing my master's, because I still remember he brought the documentation to my house and said, you have to study. So I think friends like that should always be treasured. So George is a great friend to have. And more than that, his contribution to the country is phenomenal. Chris Sosa, she really has mothered me many a times. Like, I will never forget the amount of help that Chris has done. Even especially when I lost my mom, she was there by my side, both of them. So
why do you have to include him now?
Sorry.
You didn't include me when you were talking about him. Unnecessary, Danu, right?
Sorry, Chris.
Yeah.
Take two. Chris is the best.
Thank you. No, you said less of me.
You interrupted. No, I was going to say more.
Gave him a glowing report. And as usual, I'm like the pariah in this.
Chris is our Joan of Arc.
You lost me there. On that note, we need to wrap things up on the show. Thank you for being on the show. We will see you soon. Till then, you keep smiling. It's a wrap.